pull the conversation forward.
Okay.
You spoke about time. I want to contextualize time in two different ways here.
Okay.
If anger can turn to calm, it can also turn to anger again.
Yes, of course.
So again, time is not the comfort zone that we can look at very dependably, because it changes.
Yes.
So could change be the comfort that we are looking at, this constant sense of change? If we are in the middle of something and we allow ourselves the possibility of, I bring this up because generally the Buddha has spoken about impermanence quite often.
Right.
And my own practice also helps me understand this, but this is the first time it has organically fallen in place as far as our chat is concerned.
Okay.
Would change be a good place to park our comfort? Just knowing that right now when I'm talking to you, we are both enjoying each other's company in this chat. Some turns out to be a very good chat and all that stuff. But this will not stay.
Right.
Time will pass and we'll either look back at it with fondness or as laugh at ourselves or anything. Maybe the technology itself will seem very kiddish. We do not know what is in the future.
Right.
So do you think change is a good place to park our minds in, accepting that things will change as a base on which we experience things?
Yes, I think, well, if I have to look at it from your perspective, I would say change is also a very good escape. But to be honest, change is the only thing that keeps us going. That's so true, because if I have to look back on all my life experiences, all I realize is that there was constant change. I was never at a place where I would say, oh yeah, okay, this is, even if it is about home, my home also has changed, and I think it can further on, right? So the sense of comfort we're talking about is actually change. Change is the only thing that can, you know, help you, outgrow anything, even yourself, even your, you know, expectations from yourself, from others, your experiences, for good, for bad. But I think change is always going to be a part of our life, and I think that's something that is beautiful about life. Actually, we learn a lot with it.
Yeah. Well, since you are in NYC, you can pick up the call and call Mr. Trump. Who did not realize things have changed.
Well, yeah,
it's difficult. There are a lot of people trying to convince him.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
Care on a. So I want you to contemplate a little more on this change thing, and if you were to, in the present time, use it.
Right.
How do you think it will result in a positive way? Besides, you gave us a generic overview of how change has helped you, because it gives you a perspective. You can look at things in a manner where you can make your peace with it. Where our memories are such that your auntie and your shifting will one day get muddled up, and you will not know what is what, and our bodies are. But that's a bigger perspective. But if you were to, I will give you one nice line to trigger off something in case it works for you.
Okay.
There's a book called Journey to Ixalan by a guy called Carlos Castaneda. Some people call him a fraud. Some people say he's a genius or whatsoever. He goes to meet a mythical character called Don Juan.
Okay.
In search of a plant called peyote, which kind of help. If you have it, it like creates different levels of hallucination or
okay,
that kind of thing.
Okay.
So there was a line in that. He said, one should always remember that death is sitting on the left of your shoulder.
Okay.
And then you can never take a step wrong.
Right.
Because then you're very clear that this is what I want to do with it. Because you know that we are mortal. While it's a very profound statement, and I think it takes a lot to reach that stage.
Yeah, then, absolutely.
But I think we've taken our kindergarten step at this chat in terms of coming to a point where we are saying, okay, change has to be embedded in some way. How do you think it is going to help? If one were to use that example as a very strong example, obviously.
But yeah, that is a very strong example. But
how will that kind of change help? That so basically tells you you're dying this moment. Oh, you're dying this moment. What do you think would happen?
You would start living your life instantly.
Yeah. So what do you mean by living your life instantly? I think we are living it, no?
Yes, but I think it's like living life is something that not everybody does, is what I feel. There are very few people who actually understand the meaning of it and live, you know, the way they really want to live their life. And there are some like us who are just existing. It's a part of how we are living life. You know, you're just carrying on with each day. Every day is a new day, but then you're like, you know, doing your chores, you're doing your work. The day is done, it's over. You're not really living it. It's just, you're just surviving it. So
would you mean that even if you're doing your daily chore, you need to bring some kind of mindfulness or some kind of
contemplation
to what is being done? Because that may be the time that the person on the left of the shoulder says, you're done.
Exactly, right? What if you were to die, and what all would you want to do really? You would want to do everything in that probably 1 hour that you're left with, or even 5 minutes that you're left with, right? That's my whole point. So being mindful, of course, yes. But apart from that, really living happens when you actually are aware, you realize that life is short. You have to, you know, just go ahead and live every moment. And I think there are very few people I know in my life. I'm not included in that list, but who are really living their life. And they are content. They're that eternal feeling of content they have. That's why. Their attitude is completely different. And it's, I think that's what brings so much quality to their life.
Are you moving towards that? Do you think you're moving in a, maybe in a subconscious manner?
I don't know, actually. But yeah, if I have to think that living my life, yes, I feel that probably I will be there someday. I feel like I've started. It's a small step, but I will be there. That's what I feel. One day at least, I would hope to be.
Yeah. There was a very random example that came to my head from the painting example that you gave, where that you drew a line and it kind of, you overdrew it or something happened which now wasn't fitting in the context that you wanted.
Right.
So if we, I was thinking about people, you said a lot of us do not live, we simply exist or we somehow survive the day.
Yeah.
And I was looking within myself, and there are days when you think you're not good enough, or you are, oh, wish you had this or that. Again, the expectations game.
Yeah.
So we are like those lines that wanted to be the line that you were drawing, but actually we have become something else.
Else altogether, yes.
So maybe purpose is the abstract art that we need to accept. We find purpose in what we are doing, because life,
or a changing purpose perhaps,
which is also possible, because if I remember your own journey, you moved from writing to art in a far more definitive manner than you ever did earlier.
Yeah, exactly. Yes.
And then how can I hold you on to art because tomorrow you might say, I want to do interior design, or you want to suddenly move to doing something else altogether.
Right.
I have a cousin who's a research scientist.
Mm-hmm.
And her mother was telling me that she's saying she now wants to become a yoga teacher.
Oh, nice.
So, like, she's saying you studied so many years and like science and...
Yeah, it's like too...
Scholar.
Yes.
And yeah, you know, yoga teacher of all the things. But I said, yeah. So how does it matter? That's what makes her happy, and that's what the beauty of the... She says, no, I don't want to spend all my life inside a lab.
Right.
It's too much of claustrophobic living. I want to go out, meet people and do things, and that's what I want to do. So it's such a beautiful thing when you contextualize beyond the given limitations that we have set on ourselves.
Absolutely.
What I'll end up doing most of the times in the episode is try to get a hang of what values we traversed during the chat. So I'll try and bring up a bit of a sum up if it kind of works.
Sure.
We started with not having a handle on our minds and reacting with whatever emotion took over. And right. One of the examples that we took was anger, but it could be very well lust or greed or arrogance or pride or any such. Anything can take over our minds, and during that point of time, we do not have the capability to handle things correctly.
Right.
In your case, you were graceful enough to just ask for space for yourself. Some of us are not as wise. We want to have the last word, and that lands up creating even more trouble.
Right.
One of the things that one can do is not express a negative mindset necessarily. Just make peace with it at that moment anyhow if you can. And stay quiet, because there might be some answer in the silence. Could be one of the values that stands out for me.
Okay.
Then we moved on to understanding that actually speaking what we are seeking is the comfort which may not necessarily be in a physical or a mental space to share with another person or another event or another happening. Because we also had two different examples. One is where you're had a fight with your husband. On the other hand, you had a fight with your own self in terms of a painting that you were trying to achieve.
Right.
And then as we went along, we realized that was actually a state of the mind, because you had held on to this is what should happen. The value that saved you was the humility of saying, okay, I do not have to be right always. I will relook, I'll create space. And you landed up changing the context of the painting and maybe salvaging whatever you could
do. Yes.
As a creative, I want to bring in, sometimes it turns out to be the better idea than what we had thought.
That's true. Happens with me. Yeah.
So we may have the best idea about a certain thing is not necessarily true is another lesson that I would want to take home that should give us some sense of humility. From there, you moved on to a far more deeper space when you spoke about a bereavement you had in the last couple of months. Again, realizing that the mind is holds on to the idea, the expectation of wanting to have said something or spent more time or seeing her or not seeing her. But the funda of truth is God being that it is what it is. It's non-negotiable for all of us.
Right.
Very omnipresent and all powerful and can't be won over. You just have to
accept. Yeah. True.
But instead of seeing it as a negative, we were contemplating that if we were to internalize it, it could lead to better things because it gives us a holistic perspective. Like you were re-looking at it, like a lot of residences have been changed, mental spaces have been changed.
Yeah.
That's the point. Where you are comparatively more content.
Yeah.
I don't say that you reached home yet, but you are on the
path. I'm on my way.
I think that is a good way to look at your own journey. And I must thank you for this genuinely meaningful chat that turned out.
Thank you. I'm glad it did.
Yeah. So in terms of escaping unhappiness, I think we just have to make our friendship with the unhappiness a lot more stronger.
Yeah.
Accepting it for happiness to spring forth.
Yes, absolutely.
Anything you want to add to that, or else I'm good.
I think I just want to add about change.
Yeah.
Since you mentioned it, I feel that change is such a beautiful thing about life, because you're constantly put in different situations, and you know, just embracing it will only make it make you better. Actually, you'll just transform. You'll be so much wiser by the end of it, because you'll have learned something new. You would have taken home something new. And home, when I say home, it's taking home something new.
Yeah.
So I think that's also one important part of what I realized in our chat today. Something that you don't really think about in your day-to-day life. It's just like, you know, you're surviving. You're just existing. But if you have to, you know, go deeper and, you know, think about things that have actually helped you become a better person. It's actually change in every way, good, bad, all of those lessons. It's a beautiful thing.
I think, I like how you summed it up, so I will not say anything. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. It was a wonderful chat. I loved it.
Yeah. Thank you so much. I'll see you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.